Hey everyone, this is Rashmi and today I am going to discuss about the next part of this question paper. Already we have solved after the question number 2. This is question number 3. Find the value of 7 log 16 by 15 plus 5 log 25 by 24 plus 3 log 81 by 80. In this question, first value is given log 16 by 15. Here we will use the formula log m by n. The value of log n by n is log m minus log n. So here this is 7 log 16 minus log 15. Next value is 5 log 25 minus log 24, then plus 3 log 81 minus log 80. Now we will try to express the value 16, 15, 25, 24, 81, 80 as a power or product of some prime number. Now 16 is the value 2 to the power 4. 2 is a prime number. Then 15 can be written down as a 3 into 5. So 3 into 5. Next value 5. 25 can be written down as a 5 square. Then minus 24 is equal to 8 into 3. Then plus 3, 81 equal to 3 to the power 4. Then minus log 80 is equal to 16 into 5. Now again we know the formula log, suppose base value is equal to a, b to the power n, then this power can be written down in front of b. So n log b a. Here log 2 to the power 4, this value can be written down as 4 log 2. Now log 3 into 5, again we know the formula log m into n. This can be written down log m plus log n. So log 3 into 5 will be log 3 in plus log 5. This is the bracket. Now let us write down the next value, this one. This is plus 5. Again log 5 is square. Log 5 is square can be written down from this formula b to the power n. So this value will be 2 log 5. Then again log 8 into 3. That means again it is same with this formula log m into n. So we can write down log 8 plus log 3. Now plus 3, again log 3 to the power 4. 3 to the power 4 will be write down from this formula 4 log 3. Again 16 into 5, similar with this formula. So we can write down minus log 16 plus log 5. Now this value is 7 4 log 2. Before the bracket it has the symbol minus, so we can write down minus log 3 minus log 5. Now the next value, this is 5. This is 2 log 5. Now again minus in front of the brackets, that's why we can write down minus log 8 minus log 3. Now this value 3, 4 log 3, again we have minus in front of the bracket, that's why we can write down minus log 16 minus log 5. Now let us simplify the values. First value, this one, 7 into 4, the value is equal to 28 log 2. Now if you multiply 7 with these values, you get 7 log 3 minus 7 log 5. Now the next value, 5 into 2 is equal to 10 log 5. Then multiply 5 with this value, 5 log 8 minus 5 log 3. Now this value, 4 into 3, 12 log 3. Then multiply 3 with this value, 3 log 16 minus 3 log 5. Now see here, we are getting minus 7 log 5 plus 10 log 5, then minus 3 log 5. Now if we combine this value, minus 7 minus 3, the value is equal to minus 10. That means we are getting minus 10 log 5 and it presents 10 log 5. So this value will be cancelled out. Now for log 3, we are getting the values 7, this is minus 7, this is minus 5, and this is 12. Minus 7 minus 5 is equal to minus 12. That means again if we add these two values, we will get minus 12 log 3. Again this log 3 value will be cancelled out. Now it remains the values 28 log 2, then minus 5 log 8, then this value minus 3 log 16. Now this is 28 log 2, 5, 8 can be written down as a 2 cube, then minus 3, 6 can be written down as a 2 to the power 4. So 28 log 2, again this value can be written down from this formula. If we have the power, then that power value can be written down in front of the log value. So here already we have minus 5, this is 3 log 2, then minus 3 already present, then 4 can be written down here and log 2. So this will be 28 log 2, then minus 15 log 2, then minus 12 log 2. Now 28 log 2 minus 15 minus 12, the value is equal to minus 27 log 2, or 28 minus 27 equal to 1, that means log 2. So the answer of this question is equal to log 2. Let us discuss the question. Find the value of k if k minus 3, 2k minus 3 and 4k plus 3 are in Zp. So here in case of Zp, here 3 numbers is given, which are given in the variable k. So suppose if a, b, c are in Gp, then b square is equal to ac. If 3 numbers, so we denoted the numbers as abc. If 3 numbers in Gp, then we can write down b is the mid number, b square is equal to the product of the extreme number, so b square is equal to ac. Now let us start the solution. We will use this concept here. Here 3 numbers is given, k minus 3, 2k minus 3 and 4k plus 3. So here 2k minus 3 is the mid number. So we can write down 2k minus 3 whole square, then k minus 3 into 4k plus 3, k minus 3 into 4k plus 3. Now this is a minus b whole square, that means a square plus b square minus 2ab, and let us find out the product of these values. So here first we will multiply this value by this one and then this value by minus 3. So k into 4k plus 3, then minus 3 into 4k plus 3. 2k square will be 4k square, 3 square value is equal to 9, this value will be 12k. Now this is 4k square plus 3k, then minus 12k minus 9. Now see, 4k square is present in both the side, so we can cancel out 4k square. Now minus 12k minus 12k is also present in the both side, so we can directly cancel this value. So it remains the values 9, then 3k minus 9. So we can write down 3k is equal to 9 plus 9, that means 18, or k will be 18 by 3, that means equal to 6. So we have to find out the value of k, and after solution we got that the value of k is equal to 6. Now let us discuss the next question. If a square plus b square is equal to 14ab, then prove that log a minus b by root 3 is equal to half 2 log 2 plus log a plus log b. It is given that a square plus b square equal to 14ab. Now we have to prove this value. Now since in this value we have got this a minus b, that means we have to express these values as a minus b whole square. So how to make this a minus b whole square? We can add a square plus b square minus 2ab to the both side, minus 2ab. So left hand side value become a minus b whole square. Now 14ab minus 2ab, the value is equal to 12ab. Now we will apply log to the both side. So log a minus b whole square, log 12ab. Now according to the formula of log a minus b whole square, this value can be written down as a 2 log a minus b, because we know that log b to the power n, the formula is n log b, that means whatever formula we have, what is the power of this value, we can be written down in the front of log. So by using this formula we have written down this step, 2 log a minus b. Now for this step, it will be, suppose there are 3 values m and p. M and p are 3 variable, so we can expand the formula as log m plus log n plus log p. Now we can write down log 12 plus log a plus log b. Now we have to prove this one. So for this one we can write down the value as 2 log a minus b, then 12 can be written down as a 4 into 3 plus log a plus log b. Now 2 log a minus b, again 4 into 3, this value can be written down as a log 4 plus log 3 plus log a plus log b. Now let us move this value to the right hand side. So it becomes 1 by 2 log 4 plus log 3 plus log a plus log b. Now log a minus b, see in the question in the right hand side, half 2 log 2 plus log a plus log b. See here we are getting these values, half is here, log a, log b is here. 4 can be written down as a 2 square, and log 3 we will move this value to the left hand side. So here half is multiplied here, so we can write down half log 3. Then let us keep the other values in between the bracket. 4 is equal to 2 square and plus log a plus log b. Now this is log a minus b. Half means again we can use the formula. Here it becomes root 3, 3 to the power half. So we can write down log root 3. Then this is half, 2 square can be written down as a 2 log 2 plus log a plus log b. Now a minus b, let us move this value to the left hand side. Root 3 equal to half 2 log 2 plus log a plus log b. Now this value combinedly we can write down a minus b by root 3, and in the right hand side half 2 log 2 plus log a plus log b. So this is the final answer which we have to prove. Let us discuss the next question. If ABC are in GP and if P is the arithmetic mean between AB and Q is the arithmetic mean between BC, show that A by B plus A by P plus C by Q is equal to 2. First condition is given, ABC are in GP. If 3 number is given in GP, then we can write down midterm square is equal to product of the extreme terms. So B square is equal to AC. Now two another condition is given, P is the arithmetic mean between AB. P is the arithmetic mean between AB. So whenever a value is the arithmetic mean, we can write down P is equal to A plus B divided by 2. Now the next condition is given that Q is the arithmetic mean between BC. So according to the formula, we can write down Q is equal to B plus C divided by 2. Let us give, this is number 1, this is number 2, this is number 3. Now we have to prove this value is equal to 2. So let us write down left hand side. So in the left hand side the value is A by P plus C by Q. Now we have already find out P and Q value. So let us substitute here. P value is equal to A plus B divided by 2. Then Q value is equal to B plus C divided by 2. So this is from 2 and 3. Okay, from 2 and 3 we have got this value. Now let us simplify the value. It becomes 2a divided by a plus b, then 2c divided by b plus c. Now we can take the LCM of these two value. So a plus b into b plus c. Now if we take the LCM this value, so it will be 2a into b plus c, then plus 2c into a plus b. Now a plus b into b plus c, we can multiply like this, a into b plus c plus b into b plus c. And let us simplify the values. 2ab plus 2ac, then plus 2ac plus 2bc. So from the numerator we can take the value common 2, so it remains ab plus ac plus ac plus bc, and the denominator will be ab plus ac plus b square plus bc. Now see, in the right hand side we have to get the value 2. So for getting value 2, this value should be cancelled out in between the bracket value. Now see here, ab same value, ac same, bc same, but this value is only different, b square and ac. But we have already got one condition, that abc are in gp. So from this formula we have already got that b square is equal to ac. We have given this condition number 1. So we will substitute this value to the given step. So let us write down 2 into ab plus ac plus b square plus bc, then ab plus ac plus b square plus bc. Now see, all the values are same, so we can cancel the value. It remains equal to 2, which is equal to right hand side. So hence proved. Let us discuss the next question. Integrate log 10 square p divided by 1 plus x square by dx. Now for this solution, first of all we assume that 10 inverse x as a some another variable. So let us assume that p is equal to 10 inverse x. You can assume any other variable. Now let us differentiate to the both side with the with respect to x. So dp by dx, then ddx of 10 inverse x. Now 10 inverse x, the value is 1 by 1 plus x square. So we can write down this is dp. Now dx move to the right hand side. So dx by 1 plus x square. Okay. Now we will arrange this value. So this is log 10 inverse x. Now we will arrange the term dx by 1 plus x square. Since we assume that 10 inverse x as a p, so let us substitute here, and dx by 1 plus x square, we have already found that the value is equal to dp. So now here we got integration of log p dp. Here we have to apply the formula I let. What is the meaning of I let? I means inverse formula, L means log, A means algebraic, T means trigonometric, E means exponential. This value or this formula will be used when there is a product of two variable or two function in case of integration. Here we can assume that there is the value integration 1 into log p dp. Now 1 is a algebraic value. See here, L is before A. That's why here L, that means log will be the first function and algebraic function will be the second function. Euler formula here order defines the first function or second function. Since here L stands before A, that's why log will be now first function, 9. Algebra will be the second function. So this is the formula. Suppose integration of uv dx. Here u and v are two different function. We considered it u is the first function, then v is the second function. So how to write down the formula? First function, then integration of second function, then minus integration. Now differentiate the first function and then write down, basically just again repeat this value but with some modification, and this is integration of second. And for this integration sign we have to write down another dx value. So this formula will be used here. So now according to Euler formula, log is the first function, so we will write down first function log p integration into second function. If we multiply it 1, then it remains dp. Now minus integration into differentiation of the first function, then integration of second function, and for integration sign we have to write down dp. Now this is log p, integration of dp is equal to p. So this formula is according integration of x to the power n dx. This value is equal to x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Now here in case of 1, we can assume that this is x to the power 0, because x to the power 0, the value will be 1. So the value will be 1 dx. Now in case of x to the power 0, by applying the formula we can write down x to the power 0 plus 1 divided by 0 plus 1, that means x by 1, that means x. So we can say that integration of 1 dx is equal to x. Here we have the variable p, that's why integration of dp will be p. Now minus integration, differentiation of log p will be 1 by p, and this is integration of dp, bracket close, dp is here. P, let us write down the value p in the front, so p log p, then minus integration 1 by p, integration of dp is equal to p. This is dp, this is p log p, then 1 by p into p cancel out, so here remains 1 dp, or p into log p minus integration of dp. Again see, we are getting the same value, integration of dp. We know that what is the result of integration of dp, that means p log p minus p. Now since here in this step we have removed all the integration sign, that's why you have to write down one constant of integration. I have written down c as a constant of integration. Now since p is not the actual variable, we consider that p is equal to tan inverse x. So now let us substitute the value here, tan inverse x into log tan inverse x minus tan inverse x plus C. So this is the final result. Now let us discuss the next question. The next question is that the marginal cost of a product is given by this value and the fixed cost is known to be this. Find the total cost function. Here marginal cost denoted by MC is given that 20 plus 30x minus 15x squared. We have to find out the total cost function. Now for the total cost function, we know the formula that total cost is equal to integration of marginal cost and variable is dx. So if we integrate the marginal cost, then we got the value of total cost function. So now let us substitute the value of marginal cost. Since the variable is given in x, that's why we have directly write down as a dx. Suppose some another variable is given, then we have to write down that value. Now this is 20 plus 30x minus 15x square dx. Now we can separately write down the values, integration of 20 dx, then plus integration of 30x dx, then minus integration of 15x square dx. Now here 20, 30 and 15 are the constant value. So we can write down this constant value outside the integration sign. So 20 integration of dx, then plus 30 integration of x dx, then minus 15 integration of x square dx. Now here we have to remember one formula, integration formula. Integration of x to the power n dx, the value is equal to x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Now here first of all this is given integration of dx. Now what is the meaning of integration of dx? Integration of meaning is 1 into dx. Now 1 can be written down as a x to the power 0. X to the power 0, the value is equal to 1. So by using this formula we can write down x to the power 0 plus 1 divided by 0 plus 1, that means x by 1 or equal to x. So we have got that integration of dx is equal to x. Now the next value, integration of x dx. Integration of x dx. Now x means it has invisible power 1. That means we have 1. So according this formula, n is equal to 1. So we can write down x to the power 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1. That means x square divided by 2. Now this thing, integration of x square. Integration of x square dx. Here n value is equal to 2. So we can write down x to the power 2 plus 1 divided by 2 plus 1 or x cube by 3. So now let us substitute the values here. We have got that integration of dx is equal to x. So this is 20x. Now plus 30 integration of x dx. Integration of x dx is value x square by 2, then minus 15. Integration of x square dx, the value is x cube by 3. So we can write down x cube by 3. Now since here all the integration sign is removed, that's why now we can write down constant of integration, that means plus c. Now we can now simplify the values. Here 20x, now 30 can be divided by 2, so it is 15x square. 15 can be divided by 3, so minus 5x cube plus c. Now here in the given question, the condition is given that fixed cost is known to be rupees 500. Now in case of fixed cost, so for x equal to 0, fixed cost is equal to total cost. So you have to remember this condition. For x equal to 0, that means for the variable is equal to 0, total cost is equal to fixed cost. Now what will we do? We will substitute the values here. Then we can find out the value of c. So whenever x equal to 0, fixed cost is equal to total cost. So we can write down total cost according to this formula. This is total cost. So this is 500 equal to 20 into 0, x equal to 0, then 15 into 0 square minus 5 into 0 cube plus c. So all the values will be 0, 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus c. That means c value is equal to 500. So what is the motive of using this value? By using this value, we have find out the constant of integration. So we can write down, therefore total cost is equal to this value, 20x plus 15x square minus 5x cube plus 500. So this is the total cost function.